some of y'all have thought in your little infinitesimal minds, amen, that you know exactly what I'm about to say. Amen. But I guarantee you, you ain't heard me preach like we're doing tonight.
My God.
Amen. Because I'm going to be on a subject, amen, that many really preachers don't touch on. Amen. Glory to God. Is that all right?
Yeah.
All right, come on. Let's get it on. And I'm not talking about no flesh. I'm talking about let's get it on in Jesus. Amen. Glory to God. Elder Harris, amen. I need you for one moment. Amen. You got your Bible.
Amen.
Amen. I need for you to read Ruth, the first chapter. And the most of this, amen, is going to be about this. Going to be my preach sermons on you. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. They told me I preach in the key of G. Amen. I don't know. Amen. Glory to God. But we're going to be ready to go. Is that all right?
All right.
Amen. I've been a long time to say it. Come on, Elder. Amen. Come with me for an amen, Lord God. Amen. Please stand, amen, for the reading of the Holy Writ. Amen. Out of respect and reverence for the Lord God. Amen, Lord God. Come on, Elder. You'll read for me.
1 and 1.
Amen. Start at 1. Amen, Lord God. We'll go from there. Amen. Come get the mic. We want everybody to hear this.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. Now it came to pass in the days when the judges ruled that there was a famine in the land. And a certain man of Bethlehem, Judah, went to sojourn in the country of Moab. He and his wife and his two sons. And the name of the man was Elimelech, and the name of his wife, Naomi. And the name of his two sons, Malon and Chilion. Ephratus and Bethlehem, Judah, and they came into the country of Moab. And continued there in Elimelech, Naomi's husband died, and she was left, and her two sons. And they took the wives of the woman of Moab. The name of the one was Orpah, and the name of the other, Ruth. And they dwelt there about 10 years.
Yeah.
And Malon and Chilion died also, both of them.
My God.
And the woman was left of her two sons and her husband. Then she arose with her daughters, with her daughters-in-law, that she might return from the country of Moab. For she had heard in the country of Moab how that the Lord had visited his people and given them bread. Wherefore she went forth out of the place where she was, and her two daughters-in-law with her, and they went on the way to return unto the land of Judah.
You may have seen it. Continue reading.
And Naomi said unto her two daughters-in-law, go return each to thy mother's house.
Yeah.
The Lord deal kindly with you, as ye have dealt with the dead and with me. The Lord grant you that ye may find rest, each of you, in the house of her husband. Then she kissed them, and they lifted up their voice and wept. And they said unto her, surely we will return with thee unto thy people. And Naomi said, turn again, my daughters. Why do you go with me? Are there yet any more sons in my womb, that they may be your husbands? Turn again, my daughters. Go your way, for I am too old to have an husband. If I should say, I have hope, if I should have an husband also tonight, and should also bear sons, will you tarry for them till they were grown? Will you stay for them from having husbands? Nay, my daughters, for it grieved me much for your sakes that the land of the Lord is gone out against me.
Yeah.
And they lifted up their voice and wept again. And Orpah kissed her mother-in-law, but Ruth clave unto her.
Yes.
And she said, behold, thy sister-in-law is gone back unto her people and unto her gods. Return thou after thy sister-in-law. And Ruth said, entreat me not to leave thee,
amen,
or to return from following after thee.
Amen.
Come on, put your hands together, give God praise. I know I'm a little long, but I need to make a point tonight. Amen, glory to God. Amen. For a topic on a subject, look at your neighbor as a neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
It's time
to let it go.
Okay.
Look at somebody else and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor. It's time to let it go. Come on, put your hands together, give God praise in the house. Amen, glory to God. It's time to let it go. What has happened in the body of Christ? Somehow, amen, glory to God, amen, elder, amen, the church has been suffering from an identity crisis. Amen, glory to God, and do not have any idea or recollection, amen, about who they are in the world. Amen, glory to God, Bishop, how can you say this? Amen, glory to God, because it seems funny to me, amen, how we can be so easily convinced, amen, glory to God, to leave, amen, glory to God, the predestined place, amen, that God had planned for us. Amen, glory to God, because there's so many doctrines, and there's so many things, amen, that on everybody has a title, glory to God. Help me right now. Church, amen, glory to God, having other ministries to come under a fellowship,